welterweight division, 8 3-minute rounds. Mark McCreath from Lincoln against Peter Till from Bloxwich in the West Midlands. Till, very experienced, 25 wins, 11 losses and a draw. Here he comes, and Mark McCreath, well, he's won 13 of his 16, he's lost three, and his last loss was in fact an 11th round stoppage at the hands of Valerie Kayumba for the European Championship in Paris in March. Here he comes, Mark McCreath. He turned pro in Belgium, of all places. And that Kayumba fight was his second tilt at a European title. He actually boxed Pat Barrett in April of 91, lost in six rounds, but had Barrett on the floor. Also holds the Benelux Welterweight Championship, beat Freddy de Moulinaire in five rounds on a cut in Waregem in Belgium in 91, just after the Barrett fight, in fact.
Ladies and gentlemen, we continue with the light welterweight contest of 8 3-minute rounds between introducing in the blue corner, wearing black trunks from Warsaw, the lightweight champion of the Midlands area, Peter Till.
So there is then the lightweight champion of the Midlands, Peter Till, 29 years of age now.
And in the red corner, wearing the white trunks with the light blue trim from Lincoln, the challenger for the light welterweight champion of Great Britain, Mark McCreath.
There's Mark McCreath, and the champion will feature of Great Britain will feature after this, Andy Holligan.
Today's weigh-in, McCreath, Tilskate, Stale, 10 stone, McCreath, 10 stone, 1 pound. Your referee for this contest, Mr. Jim Pridding.
So here we go then. And McCreath actually started life. He's in fact boxed as high as about 10-4. But Jamie Lightwell, he's got Brendan England in his corner. I do believe that Brendan might just be taking over the reins of McCreath's career. I know he's been doing a bit of work in the Ingle gym. So, round one then. Mark McCreath in the white against the hard-punching Peter Till. And Till seconded tonight by the father of Richie Woodall. I think it's Ron. Do forgive me if it's not. I'm sorry. Been a while since we've seen each other. So the shaven skulled Mark McCreath then. Former ABA welterweight champion, won that back in 1988. Also got a silver medal at the Multi Nations tournament in Finland in the same year. Boxed in the Acropolis Cup in 88 as well. In Athens, lost to a Swede, and also represented England and won against the Czech. So Peter Till then, the reigning Midlands area champion. In fact, he's the Midlands area champion at lightweight, one weight below this. Had a cracking fight with Michael Ayers and eliminated for the British Lightweight Championship. Lost in five on an injury to Ayers, but Till, I think, was on the floor three times, and I think Ayers was on the floor a couple. And Till a pro now for some time. April 85, he turned pro. McCreath turned pro 4 years later. Peter Till, a good amateur, well, in 84, in fact, he got to the ABA light welterweight semi-final. Beat Keesum Clayton on the way there. And lost to Billy Buchanan for a place in the final. And that fight that McCreath had with Valerie Kayumba was an absolute cracker, barnstorming fight. And there was hardly anything in it, and I believe that at least one judge had McCreath in front. But he kind of ran out of gas. Stopped in 11 rounds, only one to go. So inside the last 30 seconds, and at this opening round of a scheduled eight. And McCreath first fought for the Belgian Worldweight Championship back in October of 1990 against Patrick Vungbo. He was a useful fighter and lost on points to Vungbo. More recently, he's had some good form. He beat Gary Barron a couple of times as the bell ends round one, which I'll give to Mark McCreath. He also beat Chris Saunders. So some good form there on McCreath's record. I'm destined, I think, for higher things. And there's Peter Tilt. Got Denny Mancini in the corner. As I say, with Mr. Woodall. Last fight, in fact, for Tilt was reasonably impressive. He lost on points to Errol MacDonald in February. MacDonald, you might remember, fought Patrizio Oliva for the European welterweight title. And a lot of people thought he was robbed. Also boxed all over the... Boxed in... I think in South Africa, against Dingaan Tabela, lost in 9 rounds. Also fought Rashid Lawal, Mark Reefer, Michael Driscoll. And I remember in Grenoble, Till mixing it with the current European champion, Valerie Kayumba. Lost in 3 rounds to Kayumba. I must admit, Till didn't really look the part that night. Holds a couple of early wins. Back in 88, he beat Neil Haddock and Sugar Jibiliru. And Haddock is the reigning British super featherweight champion, and Sugar Jibiliru, of course, used to hold the same title. But as we're all very well aware these days, not one super featherweight champion since 1967 has retained the title, as McCreath there gets some punches together. Referee once again, Jim Pridding. My old mate, Jim. Refereed me a couple of times. Give Till a target, he'll take full advantage. He's not the man he was, I think that's fair to say. He beat Mark Reefer in 3 rounds. Of course, Reefer, a former champion. And that was a good win, in fact. Genuine. And that was his last win. So one win in his last four for Till. So far, all of McCreath's losses have come in championship fights. Two for the European, one for the Belgian welterweight title. Well, Till there got through with the left hook to the body. I think he aimed for the chin. Matchmaker Terry Tool's done a fairly interesting job with this one. Till can hurt anyone he can hit. Like that, right hand, catching McCreath on the chin. Well, I would say, in fact, Till's boxing probably as well as he's ever done here. As the bell ends the round, so two then. The two gone in favour of Mark McCreath on my card, although Peter Till had his moments there. And there's Brendan Ingle, probably one of the, I would say, the most animated corner man in the world. He's been kicked out of the corner a couple of times for being a bit too overzealous. Little left hook there from McCreath in the replay, just as Till was unloading one. Round three then, schedule for eight this. Potential of 24 minutes between these two. Not including the breaks, of course, which are 1 minute. That's left hook from McCreath. And you'd say at the age of 28, Mark McCreath is not going to get any better, so the chances are he'll desperately want a bid for either the British or the Commonwealth, sorry, the Commonwealth or the European Championship again in the not too distant future. And if Andy Holligan wins the European title when he gets his chance against Valerie Kayumba, then you might see Mark McCreath fighting for the vacant British Championship that I dare say Holligan will give up. be able to judge how Holligan and McCreath might go, because we're featuring Andy after this one. McCreath boxing well. Nice left hook from Peter Till. And again, the uppercut followed by the left hook, and McCreath says, right, let's have you. Nothing wrong with McCreath's chin. In spite of the fact that in two of his three losses, he's been stopped. Pat Barrett, tremendously hard puncher, and exhaustion costing that stoppage loss against Kayumba as much as anything. Chopping right there from McCreath, with Till backed into the corner deliberately, trying to lure McCreath onto a shot, and a chopping right there once again. Till hits the deck, sensibly taking full use of the eight count here. Well, he's up at nine, ready to carry on. And a right there, just catching McCreath off balance. Good value fighter, Till. Especially when there's a lot at stake, and a win here over McCreath will do him the world of good. Oops, and a right there from Till. Just whizzed past the head of McCreath as the bell sounded. But that's another round for McCreath, I feel. Till's always in these rounds, but he's not winning them. And Mr. Woodall told me every time I see him and mention him, I've got to say he's incredibly good looking. And he gives me a few quid every time I do, so I'll just repeat that. Here's the chopping right that put Till on the floor. Didn't help him, of course, because he was bent over at the time it landed. So into the fourth. And fans of domestic British boxing, obviously have a keen eye on this one. And I can only remember Till in one stinker of a fight, and that was, believe it or not, against Ray Newby in Birmingham. And he and Newby have fought three times now. And Peter Till actually embarked on an international career way back in 1987. He boxed Aladdin Stevens in Johannesburg and was did well, but was knocked out in four. Right again from Till. Well, now Peter Till going forward here, fancying his chances against McCreath. So Till then the senior of these two by just 1 year at 29. Boxing pretty sprightly so far. Well, this is a fairly level round at the moment. There's not too much, neither man really has had any dominance in this fourth. A good right hand there from Till. In fact, he might just be. Again from McCreath, but a nice little combination there from Tilt. Jim Pretty warns McCreath for hitting on the back of the head. Good body shot from McCreath. Still forced to cover in the corner. Well, that's not a bad round, and I think that's a fairly even round at the finish. I think Peter Tilt has earned a share of, and this was the finish, and the chopping right almost to the back of the head there from McCreath that he picked up the warning for. Bit more of that. So the halfway stage coming up in round five. And I was in Burnley the other night at Tara Promotion Show, cracking little show as well, and the great pleasure of seeing my old pal Amos Talbot again. And his beautiful daughter Nicola, and it's a good job she takes after her mother. Anyway, round five of a scheduled eight, this the halfway point. Mark McCreath in the white with the blue stripe against Peter Tilt. Still the current Midlands area lightweight champion, which I don't think he'd ever defend again because he's very chunky, isn't he? And he's coming here at the bang on the light welterweight limit of 10 stone, 63.5 kilograms. Inning in international money. Now, Peter still does have actually more success when he takes the fight to McCreath. McCreath prefers Till just to back off that half a pace to give him the range he needs. Till still in there, still having a go. And in his 13 wins, McCreath has stopped a dozen of his opponents. Only one man, in fact, has gone the distance with him. And that was Josef Rack. Whoever he may be. So Till will do well, I think, to last the limit here. He stopped 11 men in his 25 wins, Peter Till. And just to reiterate on the records, Mark McCreath has won 13 of his 16 with three losses. All the losses coming in championship fights. And Peter Till backing up on the ropes here. He's won 25, lost 11, and drawn one of 37. Still now pinned in that red corner. Gets through the right hand to the head of McCreath. Corning coming in. That's of course what he was hoping to do. Hasn't bothered McCreath any though. Just still in there sticking away. And Till can be very dangerous backed up. And McCreath now looks like he's looking for a finish here. Oh, Till looking very confident. Takes a left hook to the side of the head though, and a good round there for Mark McCreath. Kept Till pinned under pressure most of the way. So I've given him four of the first five with one even. There you see that good right hand from Till. That put McCreath off balance a wee bit. Landed kind of high on the cheekbone. but McCreath recovered well just to take charge again into the centre. This is the home straight last three rounds. And Peter Till's always had his moments in the rounds we've had so far. I think the best round he had was the fourth when he took the fight to McCreath. Punches are coming in now for Mark McCreath. Nice long jab there, the right cross. And that was a very good example. That's called the old 1-2, in case you're interested. Good round now for Mark McCreath. It's principally because I think Peter Till's not taking too many chances here by coming forward. Once again, a cracking right there, and Till nods his appreciation of that, or at least his respect for it. Hardly appreciated getting thumped. And now McCreath just keeping a wee bit of distance when he goes to work. It was possibly a bit too close in that previous round. And consequently, Till could counter effectively. Now he can't. Good right hand, good shot from Till, well timed. And the left hook. So he's not done for yet. Good little scrap this. Lovely body shot. Or was it low? Well, Jim Pridding certainly seems to think it was. And we have no mechanism in British boxing to deduct points, strangely enough, in the event of an infringement by a fighter, which is really a good shot there from Till, the right hand. And McCreath there showing his respect. That was, as I say, we have no mechanism for deducting points like they have in world boxing for infringements, and we really should have. And I hope that will be brought in very soon by the Boxing Board of Control. Seems a very sensible idea. No reason a fighter should win a fight on points, even though he might have committed infringements. A nasty cut now on McCreath's right eye. Well, I didn't see a clash of heads, so I'll assume that was a left hook from Till that's done it. Well, we've only got two rounds to go. And that was a good round, and a close one as well, but I still think McCreath's got it. And now Brendan Ingle's got some work to do on that cut. And it's spilling blood there quite readily, as you can see. So you'll have to apply the adrenaline. Nasty cut. In fact, that's exactly the same as the cut I got in my first fight. Same place, first round, though, mine. And ironically, the same referee, Jim Pridding. And yes, of course, I won every round, but he gave it a draw. I don't hold it against him, of course. Anyway, this is the seventh, the penultimate round. McCreath now badly cut. Well, not badly cut, but certainly a serious cut on the right eye. I don't think it's going to be bad enough to stop it, unless, of course, Till can reconnect with that left hook. Seems to be his best punch. And there's nothing spectacular about McCreath. He's just a very decent all-round performer. Nice boxer, can fight when he has to. Durable, in spite of those two stoppage losses. And a fair puncher, as I say, with a dozen of his 13 wins coming inside the limit. I'm just wondering how far McCreath would have got these days had he actually started his pro career in Britain rather than Belgium. Not, of course, to criticise the Belgian boxing authorities, but I don't know, it just seems like he's picking up from the beginning here. Anyway, back to the action. Nice left hook from Till, and I dare say McCreath's first thought here will be to protect that cut. but doesn't seem to be paying it too much mind at the moment. Leading again. And that's a target, of course, for Till to aim at. Good body shot again from McCreath. And Till now breathing quite hard as he goes over. This time from a cracking left uppercut to the body. And they are so hard to shake off. But he's gained Till. He'll get up, I think. Yes, he has. Ooh, very late almost. Referee Jim Priddings says box on, and I think he's lost his gum shield, and that's a very sensible move. Peter Till, get up at nine and spit your gum shield out on the way, knowing it's got to be washed and replaced. Old pro's trick there. He's learned a few things in his time, Till. So action resumes then. And although McCreath boxes out or lives in Lincoln, he's actually born in Bradford, of all places. So the second time that Till has hit the canvas was in this seventh round. He was down, remember, in the third. And now, oh, lovely punch from McCreath. McCreath looking for the finish here, trying to keep the pressure on. But Till defending well. Not all of those right hands to the body are getting through. But a good round. And once again, it's McCreath. One to go. See that body plate. Oh, look at that. And I'll tell you something, if you've ever been hit like that, you know exactly how Till was feeling at that point. They are very hard to shake off. So the eighth and final round then, timekeeper Norman Mannix calls them out for action. And it's been a very competitive fight, this one. Been a few months since Till has boxed, but McCreath put in action just a couple of months ago. As I say, in that barnstorming European title fight. Well, this looks set to go the full route now. Nice to see that Till hasn't picked up any cuts to the eyes. He does occasionally. Lovely jab there from McCreath. That's a fight winner. Again, McCreath there looking to plant that body punch. And I'm trying to think who Mark McCreath was trained by prior to, as I said, I think he's going to join Brendan Ingle. Just think of his trainer, and do forgive me, whoever you are. I should know, of course. So good work now by McCreath, boxing well here. But if he gets in to mix it, Till will take advantage. And you've got to be fit to box at this pace. Had have no trouble doing 12 rounds. The most he's ever done is 11. And prior to that, he boxed 10. But I'm sure he could do 12 at a good pace. And that blood now flowing again. Till's caught him. That right eye, the right side of his face. In fact, a mask of blood. But probably too late in the fight, really, to affect a stoppage. Nice shot there from McCreath, left hook. Doesn't throw all of his punches that cleanly. Some of them are almost cuffs. But there's plenty of them. And this has been a very game effort from Till. And that's it, all over. That looks like a good win for Mark McCreath. Well, I think McCreath won that very clearly. I only gave a share of the fourth to Till every other round for McCreath. Good performance.